the beginning of the Elgar as an example for how I try to connect the sostenuto, fortissimo notes of this grand, noble beginning with the idea of one movement. The idea of one movement I base on the breathing cycle and of the body weight. The breathing cycle brings us fresh air every time we breathe in and releases not only the air but also muscle tension when we go in the down breathing. And if we are aware of it, we can use it as a reload moment for the next action that will refill us with air and energy. This beginning of the Elgar being fortissimo requires much energy, much body action, and it is interesting how we are able to build up the musical tension in the chords and in the rest of the phrase without building up body and muscle tension. And if we breathe freely, connecting notes by finding resting moments, this is what we actually offer the audience, the possibility to breathe freely too and to enjoy the music. The first chord builds up towards the strong second chord, and we could do it by straightening the back and looking for the sound higher in order to be higher than the bow and to give him force until the tip. I prefer to do it by sitting on a chair, by sinking into the chair and using the possibility of the body to go to move sideways, move back and forward, also to move upwards if needed. But for this beginning, in order to find the flexibility of placing the fingers for next chords, because the action of playing fortissimo can stop the continuity. Also to retake the down bows, that is quite a, it has to be a flexible action. We are all built in a different way, and for longer people it would be absolutely much easier and much less strainful to stay in fortissimo. For any kind of body build, what is very important is to keep the lower back, especially the gate to free movement for the spine, free, not to tense it. The moment we tense it, we are cutting actually the airflow and we are stuck. So this is what I'm actually trying to do. Stay breathing in the notes and find for as much as possible body comfort. In this movement, I try to go sideways. It doesn't have to be a big movement, but it permits me, by staying low, also to think of the placing of the next fingers, the shift on the strings, but actually through the air. Resting on the vibrato on the upper part of the chord, I prepare for the next chord. That is not only a chord but also a bridge to the next chord, and these lines need more movement, so I need my body free. And I find another resting note on the C. Is as difficult because it stays fortissimo, and the up bow on the A tends to close the body because it has no way out, seemingly. Instead of closing, continuously placing the next fingers, using the A as a resting point, and resting not only on the finger but also on the body. To another resting point until the deepest moment on the C, where it releases all the tension of the phrase and goes towards its end. This is an option of working, of searching for the continuity. And again, the idea and the purpose is to free the sound. A free sound is a breathing sound. A breathing sound comes from a breathing body. Thank you.